Hello and welcome to St. Andrew Institute of Technology and Management, Gurgaon. I am Rohit Raj from Civil Engineering Department, and we are discussing sewage and treatment. This is 25th lecture in this course, and today we will start with activated sludge process. What is activated sludge process? Basically, when we are allowing, a recent tank or any source that could provide sufficient oxygen that is required for biological treatment, then that process is called activated sludge system. Okay, that is if it is here, that is primary effluents. Okay, now it is treated using aeration tank, that is biomass is suspended, we have aeration tank, and that process is activated sludge process when we are using aeration tank to provide sufficient oxygen that is required for the biological treatment of the waste. Okay, and then we have a secondary clarifier, and then the effluent form is secondary effluent. In this, we have already studied the attached growth culture. This is suspended growth culture. Okay. And we also need to know that for every 1 kg of BOD removal, there is 0.7 kg of biological solids formation. Means for every 1 kg BOD removed, there is 0.7 kg of biological solids formed. Now, this is the diagram is showing here the live diagrams for primary effluent coming from this. Okay, and return sludge, once they are treated, then again they are returned to this tank. This forms mixed liquid. Okay, that is mixed liquor, also called as MLSS, mixed liquor suspended solids. Okay, so this is mixed liquor, that is MLSS, primary effluent return sludge. Here it is primary effluent, here it is return sludge, and they all are mixing, that is called as mixed liquor. Now, the organism that is treating is as bacillus type. Okay, means bacillus bacteria is treating these organic wastes. We also need to study the diagram that is showing the wastewater, how it is going to treat the oxygen is required for its food consumption. Okay, so this diagram slightly showing that how inside the slime layer, we are well aware of nice now slime layer that we have studied in trickling filter also. Okay, so in that slime layer, oxygen is required, okay, for the formation of new cells also and consumption of food by the organisms. Okay, and these gases liberate, that is nitrogen, that is ammonia, carbon dioxide or water. Now, what is flocculation in waste liquor? What happens that I have given you a brief idea about flocculation earlier also, that flocculation is a process when suspended particles do not settle due to repulsive force that is generated due to the like charges between them. So it is a process to nullify the repulsive force by generation of an unlike charge. Okay, so the process of contact and adhesion, whereas the particle of a dispersion form large size cluster, means due to adhesive force that is generated due to unlike charge generated in between the two like charges, there is adhesive force, and that adhesive force leads to the formation of larger size clusters. Okay, so that is flocculation. Now this is your aeration tank. Okay, clearly you can see this is your aeration tank. Okay, and this is completely secondary clarifier. I'm giving this in a diagram again and again. Okay, so effluent grit, okay, that is preliminary treatment, that is grit chamber or bars. Okay, so after preliminary there is primary treatment, and after primary treatment there is aeration tank and secondary clarifiers, and this aeration tank involves involves in activated sludge process. Now there are three steps in biological wastewater treatment, that is transfer of food from the wastewater to the cell. Okay, means first the wastewater, the extraction of food from the wastewater to the cell that is consuming that. So that requires adequate mixing and having enough detention time. Means there should be proper mixing of wastewater and there should be a proper required detention period. Okay, detention period should be sufficient for the purpose. Another is conversion of food to new cells. Okay, so once they are available to the required microorganisms, they get converted into new cells and we have a byproduct for that. And what is that byproduct? That byproduct may be carbon dioxide, that may be ammonia sometimes. Okay. So second step is conversion. First step is transfer of food. Second is conversion of food. Third is flocculation and solid removal. Third is flocculation. What is flocculation? Flocculation is basically allowing the suspended particles to settle just by adding some third source. Okay, that generates an repulsive force. Sorry, that nullifies a repulsive force. Okay. So this allow flocculation means allowing particle to settle down, and then we have solid removal. First is for transferring food. Second is conversion of food into new cells and byproducts. And third one is flocculation and solid removal. Okay. And we must have control on proper growth of environment, proper growth environment for bacteria. Okay. And we also have control on the mixed liquid. Do not compact, means there should not be bulking. Okay, we need to check with this that there should be no bulking. Okay, we already know what is organic loading and hydraulic loading. We need not to discuss that. We also need to calculate the BOD for the before the treatment, okay, to check the treatment rate. Now another one important point that now we need to see is the F/M, that is food to microorganism ratio. What is food to microorganism ratio? Okay, so basically M is microorganisms measured and F is the volume of, means it is actually total suspended solids present in the volume that we are treating. Okay, so basically F is the total BOD that is coming into the aeration tank. Means if we have this much of sample, okay, means volume of sample we have given and there its BOD is given, so we can multiply that to get the total BOD. Okay, that is here obtained, that is flow multiplied with the BOD. Okay, so that will be BOD in the unit milligram per liter. So F is basically the required total BOD that is coming in the aeration tank. Now we have M. What is M? Basically M is the mixed liquid volatile suspended solids, that is the concentration of solids present in the aeration tank divided by the total volume of the tank, that is calculated as M. M, we have a relation of M over here. You can see for an example, that is weight of the volatile solids, that is in milligram, and volume of the sample. Suppose for a liter, then it will be milligram per liter. Okay, so M is weight of solids present per unit per liter. Okay, means per liter we have weight of solids present in aeration tank, that is your M. F is total BOD in the aeration tank, and M is total suspended solids in the tank per liter. This is also per liter. So the final unit will be milligram per liter divided by kilogram per liter, okay, or milligram, that can be, okay. So this is all about the food by F by M ratio, food by mass ratio, that where F is the total BOD and M is the concentration of solids in the aeration tank. And how we can calculate the M, that is calculated in the concentration of suspended solids in the water, then quantity of water, okay, and weight of the solids, okay, and that is calculated in this way, okay. We know the concentration, we know the quantity, and we know the weight. We will multiply all of them, then we can calculate the M, okay. Similarly, we can calculate the BOD. We have already studied the BOD calculation. So there is an example how we can calculate the food to microorganism ratio. Okay, what is food to microorganism ratio? For a 7-day moving average, BOD is 2002. Okay, and the mixed liquid volatile suspended solid is 66185. So F1, F by M ratio will be this much divided with this. Okay, so that is 0.3. That is food to microorganisms ratio. Okay. The F by M ratio for the best treatment will vary from different facilities. Okay, that is, there is no hard and fast rule for that. This much F by M ratio is required for treatment of this, and this much required for this. But conventional activated sludge, F to M ratio should be 0.25 to 0.45, where F is total BOD, okay, that need that is present in the BOD present in the aeration tank, and M is the concentration of suspended solids per liter. So for conventional activated sludge, F to M ratio is 0.25 to 0.45, and extended aeration activated sludge, it is 0.05 to 0.15. Now we will see graph showing the growth of phase in biological system. Okay. So this graph shows the when food supply is introduced in a biological treatment system, then it starts up. Okay, means there is abundance of food and there is a few organisms that we are providing here. There is abundant food and there is few organisms. Okay, after few time, the food will start decreasing. There is lag growth and there is logarithmic growth. Okay, and finally this will meet. And then this will be reducing, and this growth will be rapidly increasing. And up to certain limit, this will increase. And after this, if no food is available, then what will happen? This will decline. Okay. So this is the trend for what? Food and microorganisms. That is food and microorganism depending on time. Okay. So this is the complete treatment for declining growth, indigenous growth, okay, and stores food, metabolized organic feed on the another one another. Then after declination of whole food, the organisms feed one another, producing less sludge. Okay. This is the graph showing the sludge production. Sludge production will be highest when the microorganisms will be highest in quantity. Okay, here you can see this is highest concentration of microorganisms, there the sludge production is highest. So this graph illustrates that the activities of microorganism in biological treatment system is related to the average age of organisms in the system, that is CRT. CRT is a controlled in a activated sludge system by wasting, which will be later discussed. Okay, what is CRT? Basically, it is the age of the sludge, and it is the control factor for the treatment of secondary waste. Okay. So, आज के लेक्चर में हम लोग एक्टिवेटेड स्लज ट्रीटमेंट प्रोसेस पढ़ने जा रहे हैं, जिसमें हम लोगों को पढ़ना है बेसिकली ऐसा ट्रीटमेंट मेथड जिसमें हम लोग कंटिन्यूसली ऑक्सीजन की सप्लाई मेंटेन करते हैं ताकि हमारा बायोलॉजिकल ट्रीटमेंट चलता रहे। ये एक सेटअप है जिसमें आप देख सकते हैं यहाँ पे एरेसन टैंक है, जिसकी मदद से हम लोग कंटिन्यूस ऑक्सीजन की सप्लाई देते रहते हैं, जिससे वो बायोलॉजिकल ट्रीटमेंट चलता रहता है। ठीक है, ये प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट के बाद होता है और इसके बाद हमारा सेकेंडरी क्लेरिफायर होता है। अच्छा, एक चीज जो हमें नीड जानना है वो है कि हमें हमेशा इसकी फेवरेबल कंडीशन प्रोवाइड करनी पड़ेगी, किसकी? माइक्रोऑर्गेनिज्म्स की, जो ट्रीट करेंगे। और कितना सॉलिड्स फॉर्म होता है, अगर एक किलोग्राम अगर बीओडी रिमूव हुआ तो कितना सॉलिड रिमूव होगा? जनरली ये 0.7 केजी होगा। अगर एक किलोग्राम बीओडी रिमूव होता है तो 0.7 सॉलिड्स फॉर्म होगा। इसके बाद हमें जानना है मिक्स लिक्वर क्या होता है, जैसे हम MLSS भी कहते हैं, मिक्स लिक्वर सस्पेंडेड सॉलिड्स। ठीक है, ये बेसिकली प्राइमरी इफ्लुएंट जो कि प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट से आया, और जो सेकेंडरी ट्रीटमेंट के बाद जो स्लज आता है उसे दोबारा जब हम लोग मिक्स करते हैं, इन दोनों का मिक्सचर को हम लोग मिक्स लिक्वर कहते हैं। और यहाँ देखिए इस डायग्राम में आपको एरेसन टैंक भी दिखेगा। ठीक है, ये टोटल हमारा सेकेंड क्लियर होने के बाद सेकेंडरी क्लेरिफायर में जाता है। ठीक है, इसके बाद हम लोग मिक्स फ्लोकुलेशन को पढ़ेंगे। फ्लोकुलेशन क्या होता है? बेसिकली जब प्राइमरी सॉरी ये ट्रीटमेंट के बाद जब वेस्ट जो है वो सेटल नहीं करते, सस्पेंडेड फॉर्म में रहते हैं, तो उसके लिए हमें फ्लोकुलेशन प्रोसेस का यूज करना पड़ता है। जिसमें क्या होता है, एक्चुअली ये फ्लोट इसलिए करते रहते हैं क्योंकि इनमें जो चार्ज होता है वो सेम टाइप का चार्ज हो जाता है जनरेट, जिससे कि वो अलग अलग रहते हैं, वो इकट्ठे नहीं होते और वो फ्लोट करते रहते हैं। तो फ्लोकुलेशन प्रोसेस में क्या होता है कि एक अपोजिट चार्ज हम लोग डालते हैं, ठीक है, कोगुलेंट टाइप मटीरियल, जिसके मदद से वो एक दूसरे के साथ चिपक जाते हैं, और फिर जब चिपक जाएंगे तो भारी होकर ऑब्वियसली नीचे सेटल कर जाएंगे। ये डायग्राम क्लियर है, इसमें पहला पार्ट जो है स्क्रीनिंग है, जिसमें हम लोग बार्स होता है और ग्रिड चैम्बर होता है, उसके बाद फिर हमारा प्राइमरी क्लेरिफायर होता है जिसमें हम PST यूज करते हैं, उसके बाद हमारा एरेसन टैंक है, एरेसन टैंक के बाद हमारा सेकेंडरी क्लेरिफायर होगा और ये इफ्लुएंट चला जाएगा। अच्छा, जब बायोलॉजिकल ट्रीटमेंट में तीन स्टेप होगा, जैसे हमारा एक्टिवेटेड स्लज प्रोसेस जो हम लोग यूज करेंगे उसमें तीन स्टेप होगा। सबसे पहला स्टेप होगा हमारा ट्रांसफर ऑफ फूड, दूसरा स्टेप होगा हमारा कन्वर्जन ऑफ फूड, और तीसरा होगा हमारा फ्लोकुलेशन और सॉलिड रिमूवल। जो फूड बन ट्रीट हो चुका है उसके बाद जो सॉलिड्स बने उनको हमको ट्रीट करना होगा। तो जब हम ट्रांसफर ऑफ फूड करेंगे उसमें हमें एक चीज चेक करना होगा कि मिक्सिंग प्रॉपर है और डिटेंशन पीरियड भी सफिशियंट है या नहीं। जब कन्वर्जन होगा फूड का उसमें हमें फूड की सप्लाई को ज्यादा नहीं जाने देना होगा, कंट्रोल करके रखना होगा, और DO को एडिक्वेट मेंटेन करना होगा, मतलब ऑक्सीजन की जो सप्लाई है वो प्रॉपर होनी चाहिए और न्यूट्रिएंट बैलेंस होना चाहिए। ठीक है, और तीसरा जो स्टेप है वो है फ्लोकुलेशन और सॉलिड रिमूवल, उसमें भी प्रॉपर मिक्सिंग होनी चाहिए, इन्वायरमेंट सही होना चाहिए माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स के ग्रोथ के लिए। ठीक है, और सेकेंडरी क्लैरिफिकेशन होना चाहिए इसके बाद। इसके बाद हमें जानना है F/M रेशियो, वो बेसिकली क्या होता है F/M रेशियो, फूड बाय माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म, फूड टू माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म्स। ओके, फूड टू माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म रेशियो जो हमें जानना है। ठीक है, बेसिकली F क्या होता है, F जो है हमारा टोटल BOD है जो कि एरेसन टैंक में है, वो कैसे निकालेंगे, BOD की कॉन्सेंट्रेशन को टोटल फ्लो से मल्टीप्लाई करके हम लोग वो निकाल सकते हैं। और M क्या है हमारा, M का रिलेशन यहाँ पे है कि M जो है टोटल वेट ऑफ वोलेटाइल सॉलिड्स पर लीटर सैंपल। ओके, तो इससे हमें निकल जाएगा F/M रेशियो जो कि है फूड टू माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म रेशियो। अच्छा, ये फूड टू माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म रेशियो होना कितना चाहिए, जनरली ये इसकी कंसर्न साइज के ऊपर में डिपेंड करती है, मतलब जितने भी पैरामीटर्स हैं उन सभी पे डिपेंड करता है। मगर कन्वेंशनल एक्टिवेटेड स्लज में ये 0.25 से 0.45 होता है और एक्सटेंडेड एरेशन एक्टिवेटेड स्लज में ये 0.05 से लेकर के 0.15 तक होता है. सो So that's all for this lecture. Thank you for listening. Feel free to ask any doubt. You can just contact on this number or you can mail on this mail ID. Thank you for listening. Take care.